for all the horticultural endeavors. Of some very well-known people in the rock and roll industry. Actually, they were green before green was really in. And the nominees for this award are Mr. Don North, Pee Wee Wilson, Little Sammy. Here's Sammy. Jimmy Doyle. Willie Fennell.
Get down, Willie.
On you. John Ryan. Ian Saxon.
Oh, be nice.
It's a long list. Digger Ravel. Hey! On your dick. Seth Martin.
Only a little bit.
And there, go on. And Mr. Barry Ward. And the winner is... Who else but Mr. Digger Ravel?
Hey!
On your digger.
Two in one night, Dig.
Thank you very much, everybody. All I can say is, I earned this one.
The beautiful Digger Ravel. Right, ladies and gentlemen, another five awards. That means another five presenters. And of course, that means another five great songs from our presenters. Would you please welcome on stage, to start the ball rolling, Mr. Barry Stanton.
Well, Mona Lisa, Mona Lisa, met half naked. Well, you're so like the lady with a mystic smile. Is it only 'cause you're lonely, met half naked too? Oh, that Mona Lisa's strangeness in your smile. Well, do you smile to tempt a lover, Mona Lisa? Or is it a sure way to hide a broken heart? Many dreams have been born to the doorstep. Well, they just lie there, and they die there. Are you warm? Are you real, Mona Lisa? Or just a cold and lonely, lovely work of art? Or to the guitar! Italian town. Well, lives a girl's beauty, seems a rose. Many urge a lover, but their hopes all tumble down. What does she want? I guess nobody knows. Ooh, you smile to tempt a lover, Mona Lisa. I reason this old way to hide a broken heart. Are you warm? Are you real, Mona Lisa? Or just a cold and lonely and a lovely work of art? Does she want? Guess nobody knows. Ooh, you smiled, attempt to love Mona Lisa. Our reason's always to hide a broken heart. Are you warm? Are you real, Mona Lisa? Or just a cold and lonely, lovely work of art? Just a cold and lonely, lovely work of art. Just a cold and lonely, lovely work of art.
I think you've done some traveling, I like to say you've been around. Like you've seen the sights of Paris or the heart of London town. Might say a night in Soho would be mighty hard to toss. Let me tell you, folks, you just ain't lived until you've seen King's Cross. Have you ever been to see King's Cross, where Sydney siders meet? There's a million faces going places, walking up and down the street. White tourists everywhere in their travels do declare, I've seen the world, you can hear them cry. Bet you a tenner to a con man's why. One is in a lot till the day you die. Have you ever been to see King's Cross? So if you're a weary traveller and you think you've seen the lot, well, take my tip and make the trip while the money you've still got. And in later conversation, you'll never, never be at loss. You can tell them all you had a ball, you went to see King's Cross. Have you ever been to see King's Cross, where Sydney's siders meet? There's a million faces going places, walking up and down the street. White tourists everywhere in their travels do declare, I've seen the world, you can hear them cry. Bet you a tenner to a con man's why. Want to see a lot till the day you die? Have you ever been to see King's Cross? No, you want to see a lot till the day you die? If you haven't been to see King Cut. Hey, want to see the lunch of the day? You know, if you haven't been to see King Cut. Thank you. Thank you very much. Let's keep the show rolling and bringing on stage right now the bombshell from New Zealand who came and made Australia her home, Dinah Lee. Let's hear it.
Baby, 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 baby
it down a tone, will you?
My God. They were really up there, those fellas. Ladies and gentlemen, please meet one of the best, the Peter Pan of rock and roll, Mr. Warren Williams.
One, two.
Caramia, why must we say goodbye each time we pass? My heart wants to die.
And now, will you put your hands together for my three sons, Warren, Darren, and Andrew. Yeah. Yeah. A 1, 2, 3, 4. Caramia, why must we say goodbye each time we part? My heart wants to die, my darling, hear my prayer. Carry me there, I'll be your love till the end of. My heart wants to die, my darling, hear my prayer. Carry me off, I'll be your love till the end of. Carry me mine, carry me mine, carry me mine.
Sing it,
carry me mine.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And now, will you put your hands together for
Uncle Digger Ravel?
Yeah!
Thank you, Warren. Well, hello there. My, it's been a long, long time. How am I doing? Oh, I guess that I'm doing fine. It's been so long now, and it seems like it was only yesterday. Ain't it funny how time slips away? How's your new love? I hope that he's doing fine. I heard you told him you're gonna love him till the end of time. the same thing that you told me. Seems like only yesterday. Ain't it funny how time slips away? I gotta go now. I guess I'll see you around. I don't know when, no, 'cause I never know when I'll be back in town. But just remember what I told you, that in time y'all gonna pay. Ain't it funny how time slips away? But just remember what I told you, that in time you're gonna pay. Ain't it funny how time slips away? Thank you very much, everybody. I enjoyed it.
That's Digger Ravel. Digger Ravel. Oh, is he all right? Yes, he is. He's here, ladies and gentlemen. How are you, mate? How are the
good,
fingers?
Mate.
Fingers
yeah,
okay?
No, we're, no, great.
Terrific, great.
Everything's kicking. Yeah. All right, where's the...
You want the nominees?
Yeah, what a good idea. No, that's the winners. Can I just, on a serious note... Yeah, I know that. No, I know that.
All right.
Can I just, on a serious note, folks, before we do go any further, because whether we like it or not, what you are seeing here tonight, for all the folk who are not part of the business here tonight... This is a bit of a different night, and certainly an original night that you'll perhaps never ever see again. For the simple reason, this is the first time in the history of rock and roll, ever since rock and roll made its inception into Australia, that all the pioneers and all the musicians and all the behind the scenes people have ever got together. And I'll tell you what, if that wasn't for this would not have all been possible if it wasn't for Leon Isaacson, Lucky Star, Warren Williams, Ron Hearn, Ian Turpie, and Clara Kay. Come on, hey, yeah. Yeah. You betcha. And as you can see, putting all these videos and everything like that together is no mean feat. All right. My purpose for being up here tonight, I can't understand how the hell I'm presenting this, but anyway, is to present the worst impersonation. Not necessarily the best playing or anything, but the worst impersonation of Jerry Lee Lewis. Starting with, oh God, this is going to be good. Roland Storm.
Yeah.
Where is he? All right, okay. Jimmy Taylor.
Yeah.
All right, moving down the list. Kevin Jacobson.
Ah.
Oh God, what a pretty conglomerate.
Bad.
Mike Singh.
Mike's
John Charters.
Johnny Charters.
Terry Wilkinson.
Who?
That's what I keep saying, right?
Terry Wilkinson.
And there's Billy Hucker here tonight. Billy Hucker.
Billy Hucker.
Where is he down the front? Ian Clifton.
Hey, Ian.
Yeah, the agent's friend, of course, tonight. Bruce Wormhold.
Yeah.
It's Brucey tonight. Where are you, Brucey Woosie? Yes. Warren Carr. Warren Carr's not here. And certainly an act that has not been able to be followed tonight besides our good friend Warren and the Suns, right? But the only fella in this town who can lift his own lid, and that's Milton Saunders, right?
Hey, yeah. Milton Saunders!
And the winner is, for the best, or I should say for the worst impersonation of... Thank you very much, Mr. Bloxon. Can't you do better than that? Because Jerry Lee Lewis was one hell of a... He was, really, yeah. And the winner... Oh, God.
It's all this giving.
And the winner of this deserves a big...
Oh, no.
We better have another timpani. That's all this fellow warrants. For the worst impersonation ever of Jerry Lee Lewis, Mr. Kevin Jacobson.
Yeah! The band don't know what's happening here, Kevin.
Right, right. Look, this is fantastic because when Jerry Lee Lewis first toured Australia, the fact is I did sit up with him night after night after night and try to learn what he did. I never did get it right. But on our last tour that we did a show called Legends of Rock as promoters, not as a rock and roll piano player. And Jerry Lee Lewis was on that tour. And he was just as mad as ever. In fact, he cost us something like $28,000.
Oh.
In.
Ah.
Because he'd walk on the plane. We were chartering planes. It'd be a 15-seater plane. He'd say, we only want 10 people on this plane. So we'd have to, or he wouldn't go. So we had to fly the next 5 people on another plane or whatever. Anyway, so I do have a little affinity with Jerry Lee Lewis. That's fantastic. Thanks.
Thanks, Kevin. Just scraped in. Kevin Jacobson. The worst version of a Jerry Lee Lewis song. The Hank B. Marvin Award is next. And to present it, Lonnie Lee. Watch the screen. Don't watch the screen. Lonnie Lee. Lonnie, don't even watch Lonnie Lee. Yes, there he is. Bloody Lee, ladies and gentlemen. This sounds very much like that.
Oh, dear. Goodness gracious me, is that embarrassing? Look at that.
Who wrote, was that little... The Jewish guy in Brisbane?
Yeah. No. That was a guy who wrote songs like Ready Teddy and Rip It Up.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. A guy called John Mariscalco.
Right.
You're thinking of Nat Kipner.
Nat Kipner, yes.
Yeah. Is Nat Kipner here tonight?
Oh, God, we hope not.
Yeah, he used to say, I got a song for you to sing to listen to. Here it goes like this. Crack, crack, crack on microphones. Oh, God. It's wonderful to be here tonight with so many people here that I even can't recognize. It's something that I've been working for myself for about 35 years, and I feel a great well of happiness seeing this happen. Unfortunately, it is a shame that today's industry, the dickheads who run the recording industry, the television industry, do not recognize where the roots come from as far as the television and the radio and the record industry. It's all sitting here, but no one gives a shit out there today. It's a shame.
I know some blokes who recognize where the roots come from.
I'm sure you do.
Would you like to read the nominations?
Yes, do you have them here? Fine. You know, prior to the Beatles and that English invasion, there were the singer out the front and the band in the back.
The guy at the front got all the bread. The guys at the back got all the girls, or their fair share of girls. And of course, it's because of the guys in the back that a lot of us made it. I know myself, because of my band, the Lehman, the various Lehmans, that is, I made it. And I thank them all and have told them that. And there's an award here that all those guys used to copy. And I guess the best band of the time around at the time was the Shadows. Remember the Shadows? I guess you copied them too.
Or the Strangers.
That's why I used to do this. Remember? Okay, they used to do all that crap. And everybody tried to copy them. So that's what this award is about here tonight. It's about the worst ones that did that. So we have, oh, I'm far out. So we have here Peter Baisley from the Devils and the Lehman.
Oh, yes.
Jesus, Peter had five left feet. Good on you. Lou Cash from the DJs.
Ah, Louie.
Yep. Dave Bridge from the Joy Boys. Good on you, Dave. Les Green from the Denver Men. Remember the Denver Men? Okay. Terry Walker.
Strangers.
Okay. John Hayton.
Hey, John.
Boy, you tried too.
He doesn't dance anymore.
Terry Hearn from Digger's Band. Sonny Neville from the Rebels.
Oh, yeah.
Sonny Neville. Goodness me. Darby Wilson from the Lehman. Actually, Darby was pretty good at it.
Yeah,
he was good at doing that as well. Paul Baker.
Yes.
Okay, and the winner is, please.
Danielle. The winner is then. Gabriel.
And the winner is John Hayden. Oh, you knew it was coming.
The best steps. Stay there, John. We'll do it. What are we trying to do to this guy? What do you got?
Table for me, okay, fine. Hank B. Marvin as well. I can't do the step now.
I could do the bloody step, John.
I was always the one that was out of time anyway. Look, I never got a chance to thank everybody else who was in charge of tonight because I didn't know. Even when I sat down at this table down the front, I thought to myself, gee, Leon's lucky getting this table right up the front, you know. How did I manage this? I didn't Jerry right up until it happened, you know. So I never got a chance to thank Clara and Leon and Lucky and Warren and Terps and everybody else who was involved in putting this on. Thanks very much, all of you. And it's good to know that we've got such good friends and in a business like this, and you get paid for it, too.
Johnny Hayden, ladies and gentlemen. Beautiful.
Thank you, Lonnie. Lonnie Lee. Next award is the Rock Patron Award. Now, this is quite a serious one, and we do need your undivided attention. This is for dedication and services in the promotion and encouragement of rock and roll music throughout Australia. And to present this award, we call upon a man who has done just that, Mr. Roland Storm.
Thank you very much. All right, now this is a very, very important award because, let's face it, when we all started, we had a lot of knockers, a lot of people who didn't support us or didn't help us. Our parents possibly were the worst offenders in this case. But there were a lot of people who gave their all to make rock and roll the great industry that it is. And let's face it, it is a great industry. And we have we've got camaraderie here tonight, as we can see by looking around. We are united in our belief in rock and roll. And these people supported us, right? For the Rock Patron Award, the nominations are Mr. Tommy Tico, Mr. Edwin Duff, Mr. Don Burrows, Mr. Jeff Harvey, Kamal. Julian Lee.
Why are people so unkind?
John Sangster. These people supported us. And the winner is... A big roll, a big roll. This is an important... Mr. Don Burrows.
Hey!
And here to accept on his behalf, the lovely Miss Sue Cruikshank, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much, Mr. Storm. I'm sure Don would love to be here with you tonight, but he had to go to the bank. So, it's nice. But I know there are a lot of things he would want me to say. The Rock Patron Award, it's a truly wondrous thing for a man who, and I know that Don would want me to say this, he always wanted to be a rock and roller. And
didn't have the chops.
I'm sure he would be here tonight, chops and all. He's never really booked me for a gig. But I'm sure had he known my talents, as I did begin in a rock and roll band called the Rat Salad Rhythm Section. Which reminds me, none of you bastards have ever booked me either. All I see is anorexic women screaming their tits off. What about a real rock and roll mama in the business? Well, that's all right now, isn't it? 1990, I've been singing since I was 4 on the back steps at home with a rolled deodorant at the microphone. Nobody booked me. I don't want to get heavy here, but I'm very good at it. Now, there's a lot of heavies in many ways in this room, and if I don't get a booking in the next 4 years, I'll be really shitty. But thanks for Don anyway. Bye.
It's so good.
Rollins Don.
She is good. Sue Cruikshank, who can really sing whatever she likes. Apart from seeing it, well, who's going to argue?
Actually, you know, it's funny. Two of the nominees were Don Burrows and John Sangster. And yet I recall on Brian Davies, on the Brian Davies show, there was, what year was that, 60? 53? Oh, he was only 4. Donnie had the band, didn't he? Am I right? Sangster was in the band? Ed Gaston? Am I right? These guys are some of the oldest rockers around. Didn't they hurry up and get out of it? Yes. Oh, no. The next award, ladies and gentlemen, is the Sandy Nelson Award. And to present it, who else but one of the worst, best, Mr. Leon Isaacson.
Ross, stop showing off.
This is the Drum Award. The Sandy Nelson Drum Award is the award for the worst version of Let There Be Drums. And that one came pretty close, didn't it? So, we've got all the old drummers here that are all the nominees. We haven't got the new wave drummers, like people that are too young for the award, like Andy Evans, he supplied the drums, and and me, I'm too young for this too. So the nominees for the Sandy Nelson Drum Award are Warren Daly, the Steeds.
The what? The who?
The Steeds. Whatever happened to the Steeds, Warren? John Bogey, the Joy Boys.
Ah! Is Bogey here? Did he front?
I don't know. He's doing a dance of the flames in the in the foyer. Catfish Purser,
yes!
The DJs.
Yes!
Tony Hopkins, the Devils.
Yeah.
Johnny Devil and the Devil.
All right, no.
Nobody's heard of these people.
Only you.
Davy Grace. The Stone Ages, no? Bill Fleming.
Yes!
Ian Crawford and the Midnighters. Or the Questions.
Any questions? Huh?
Johnny Burns, the Rebels.
Yeah.
Johnny Reb and the Rebels. Cole Bajant, the Aztecs.
Yeah.
Cole's there, I know he's there.
Yeah.
Tony Gahar, the Leeman. Well,
is Tony here?
And there have been a few last minute votes for Ian Bloxham.
Ian Bloxham, ladies and gentlemen. What group, Ian?
What group are you in, Ian? The Stoned Men.
Good evening, group.
There'll be more from Ian later.
All right. So,